क्लास 9 यूनिट 3 द लिटिल गर्ल. टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू यूनिट नंबर 3 द लिटिल गर्ल. दिस इज द यूनिट, दिस इज द स्टोरी ऑल अबाउट अ लिटिल गर्ल, हाउ शी वाज वेरी फ्राइटेंड विथ हर फादर एज शी थॉट दैट maybe his her father was very strict and all, but it was nothing like that. She realized this later on when she became a big girl or like that when she grew up. So let's understand this story. Before going to read, let's understand this. Here we have the question from the writer that do you feel you know your parents better now than when you were much younger? Student, the question is like, do you ever feel that your parents now better as you are in standard and you are quite means not a teen, you are in teenage, right? 13 or 12 or 14 around. So now your parents' behavior is better than when you were 5-year-old, when you are 8-year-old. Have you ever found this difference in your parents' behavior? Perhaps you now understand the reasons for some of their actions that used to upset you earlier. It means that child, maybe, perhaps you now understand as you are now mature, as you are in 9th standard, sorry. So you know now that when you were 5-year-old and your parents were used to upset you earlier in your childhood as you demand for something, especially we have seen these things in the fair when you want to buy all the toys and your parents strictly said not to buy. At that time you quite upset over there and you had lots of complaint regarding this, but now you understand there were the reason behind this too. Do this action by your parents. So this story about a little girl whose feeling for her father changed from fear to understanding will probably find an echo in every home. This is the story about a girl that how she changed her fearful appearance toward the father from the emotional appearance, and this probably happens in each and every house, as we generally you know, in some of the house, most of 90% the fathers are the person from whom we all frighten, right? Because they are quite strict, they are punctual, they are really, you know, wise, and so that's the reason we much frightenful from our parents, especially from father. So this happened with this girl too, but somehow when she come to understand this, that there is nothing like that, she loved her father a lot. So let's get straight to the chapter now. Here is the first part, means first we can say paragraph. Before going to understand this first paragraph, let's understand this hard word, a figure to be feared. It means a person to be feared. Figure to be feared means any person, if he or she is feared, it call a figure to be feared. Okay. To the little girl, he was a figure to be feared and avoided. He was means the father here. For the father, little girl was what? Yes, little girl, and for the little girl, father was always avoided and fearful. That she thought that my father is very much strict, and she tried to avoid her father each and every time. Avoid means she never liked to spend much time with father, as she thought he was very strict. So for him, for her, sorry, he was very fearful or avoided. Every morning before going to work, he came into her room and gave her a casual kiss. to which she responded with, "Goodbye, father." Every morning, the routine of the father and daughter is, this father came to the daughter's room and he kissed, the casual kiss means daily if this happened, the routine is this, that father come in the morning to room and he kissed on the forehead of the little girl, and in the reply, little girl only said, "Goodbye, father," and nothing. And oh, there was a glad sense of relief when she heard the noise of the carriage growing fainter and fainter down the long road. And there was a glad sense of relief means the girl became so happy when she heard, I think it means there is this street over there, and on the road, on the street, when she heard the person, the father and other daughters who were playing over there, it was giving this daughter, this girl, very relief and giving her happiness to see or to hear that voice. In the evening, when he came home, she stood near the staircase and heard his loud voice in the hall. When father came back to the home in the evening, this little girl used to stood over there at the staircase and she heard the voice. She never went in front of the father, and she never tried to ask the father how was his days and all. She just heard the voice of her father from the hall. "Bring my tea into the drawing room. Hasn't the paper come yet? Mother, go and see if my paper's out there, and bring me my slippers." Now, father used to ask these questions when he came back to the home from the office. He lay on the sofa and asked that, "Where is the paper? It doesn't come yet. And where is my tea into drawing room?" or something like that. He was loudly asked to mother. And mother immediately go and see if paper's out there or not, or bring me my slipper, like that kind of order given by the father to mother. Kezia, mother would call to her. Now, Kezia is the name of this little girl. Now, mother called this girl Kezia. "If you are a good girl, you can come down and take off father's boots." Now, mother try to order the little girl that if you are a good girl, then you should help your father. "Please take off father's boots." Slowly, the girl would slip down to the stairs. Slip down means come down, okay? Quietly and unwillingly. Unwillingly means she doesn't like to come down, but she forcefully come down. That's why it's unwilling. So, this little girl come down the stairs more slowly still across the hall and push open the drawing room door. Now finally she came to the drawing room to take off her father's boots, means shoes. By that time he had his spectacles on and looked at her over them in a way that was terrifying to the little girl. By that time means when this little girl went to the father to take off the boots, she said that it was the time when my father had a spectacle. Spectacles means chashme, okay, goggles not, but specs. When he had spectacles and looked at her terrifyingly, she thought that my father is look at me very terrifyingly, means terrifying means daravni tarike se, jab koi aapko dekhta hai very frightenful, jab aap ho jate ho, to it's called terrifying. So she thought that my father is look at me now very terrifyingly. Well, Kezia, hurry up and pull off these boots and take them outside. Have you been a good girl today? Now, I don't know, father, she replied. My father asked the question that Kezia, please hurry up, do fast. Take off my boots and keep it outside. And today, have you done any good works? You became a good girl today? Then she replied, I don't know, father. I don't know means. Now she's replied with stammering. When you are very frightened with such other person, at that time what happened? You are not giving the proper answer confidently. So at that time this happened, like tum badbadate ho, murmur karte ho, like I don't know when you are frightened. So like this Kezia answered to father, you don't know, if you shuddered like that, mother will have to take you to the doctor. Stutter means, as I told you, stuttering karna, badbadana. So father again called the little girl. See, father is very strict here. We can see that. Father again strictly called this girl that, why you are stuttered like don't. I think your mother will have to take you to the doctor as you having this problem. She never stuttered with other people. This little Kezia never stuttering like this with other people when she talked to other. She only talked to other with confidence. Had quite given it up. Given it up means stop doing it. But only with father, because then she was trying so hard to see the word properly. But this happened just because of his father was very strict. So she stuttered with father only. When she talked to father, that time this happened. But with other, this never happened. What's the matter? What are you looking so wretched about? Wretched means unhappy. I wish you taught this child not to appear on the brink of suicide. Here, Kezia carry my teacup back to the table carefully. Now, again, father asked the question to mother that, what's the matter? What's happened with this little girl? Why she was looking so unhappy today? Now mother said, I wish you taught this child not to appear on the brink of suicide. Means brink of suicide means student about to commit suicide. Now strictly this father told to mother that he wished that mother never taught this little girl to commit a suicide in fearness. Now father, see how he is using this language. Here, Kezia, carry my teacup back to the table carefully. Now again, father ordered to Kezia that, Kezia, come and please carry my teacup to that table. He was so big. His hands and his neck, especially his mouth, when he yawned. Yawn means when you are in sleeping mode, when you feel so sleepy, you do not yawning like that. So here Kezia described his father's outlook that he was so big and his hand, his neck, especially his mouth, it's looking so big when he do yawning. Thinking about him alone was like thinking about a giant. See how her daughter think about father, that she thinks that my father is like a giant. She said that when I thinking about my father, when I was alone in the room, I feel like I am thinking about one big giant. On Sunday afternoons, grandmother sent her down to the drawing room to have a nice talk with father and mother. One day, what happened at Sunday afternoon, grandmother sent this little Kezia to the hall where the father was sitting. And grandmother told to Kezia that please go and you have to talk regarding something with your father and mother. Because see, the Kezia is so frightful child. She never liked to talk with her father, with her mother. So she was very frightful or shy natured girl. But the little girl always found mother reading and father stretched out on the sofa. But whenever she went to the hall on Sunday, what the little Kezia found that mother always reading newspaper and father who laid on the sofa, stretched on the sofa. You can see in the picture that how the father was sleeping on the sofa and how the mother was busy to read the newspaper. So Kezia never tried to talk with them. His handkerchief on his face, his feet on one of the best cushion, sleeping soundly and snoring. She always found like this that her father was sleeping on the sofa and the handkerchief on the face, and you can see one leg on the cushion here, and he was making noise like snoring noise, kharate marte na, like that soundly kharate marne ki awaaz aati thi. Like this routine was there in the Sunday, at the Sunday. And how can the girl talk to their parents in this situation? The girl always found mother reading here. You can see the picture like we have given the instruction. She sat on a stool, gravely watched him until he walked and stretched and asked the time, then looked at her. Then what she did when she found her father on the sofa, she gravely, very sadly, she was waited for her father that when he woke up and when he ready to talk with her. But she found always that when he walk and stretch, he asked the time, that what is time now, then look at this Kezia. Don't stare so, Kezia. You look like a little brown owl. And when Kezia stared her father, that time father asked, told her, don't stare. Stare means constantly when we look at someone or something, it's called stare. That don't look at me, don't stare me. You are looking like an owl. Father, you know, always Kezia frightful to talk with father, and father is quite strict. That's why Kezia is very frightful, you know. One day, when she was kept indoors with a cold, her grandmother told her that father's birthday was next week and suggested she should make him a pin cushion for a gift out of a beautiful piece of yellow silk. Now one day what happened, when she was kept indoor with the grandmother, when she was alone with the grandmother, her grandmother told her that Kezia, it's better to give a surprise, to give a gift to your father, as the your father's birthday is coming soon. So you should make you should make the yellow silk cushion for your father, pin cushion for your father, pillow for the father. Laboriously, with a double cotton, the little girl stitched 3 slats. Laboriously means effortlessly. बहुत मेहनत के साथ जब हम कुछ चीज़ करते हैं तो that's called laboriously. So effortlessly or laboriously, with hard work, double cotton, little girl stitch 3 sides of that double cotton cloth. But What to fill it with? That was the question. Now little girl made the cushion cover. As you have seen the cushion, right? In the home, that cushion is filled with the cotton or somehow with such other material like waste cloth is. So now she made the outer part of the cushion, but she had a question that what I should fill inside the cushion. The grandmother was out in the garden and she wandered into mother's bedroom to look for scraps. Now, as of course, she want to ask the question to grandmother, but grandmother was not available at that time. So she went to mother's bedroom and she was searching for the scraps, for the piece of cloth so that she can stuff something like that into the cushion. On the bed table, she discovered a great many sheets of fine papers, gathered them up, tore them into tiny pieces and stuffed her case. Then she sewed up the fourth side. Sewed means silai karna, silna, okay? So when she went to the mother's bedroom, what she found? She found that, she discovered that there is on the table, on the bed table, near to the bed, we generally have the bed table in the bedroom. So she found that there is the paper in the file. So what she do? She took all the papers and she tore those papers and stuffed into the cushion. As she want to fill the space in the cushion, so she stuffed all the papers. So usne sare papers cushion ke andar bhar diye aur usko seal diya. So for the side she should. That night there was a hue and cry in the house. Hue and cry means angry protest. When the situation becomes so worst in the house, when the angry scene created by your parents, na, like that, things happen in the house at that night. Father's great speech for the port authority had been lost. Why it was, why the sin create, why the father was so angry? Because at that time, at night, father lost his great speech for the port authority. Some of the great, might be the important papers he lost, that's why. Rooms were searched, someone's questioned. Finally, mother came into Kezia's room. Mother and father searched each and everywhere in the room. They asked to the servant that where is that paper. Finally, mother came to Kezia's room to ask about those papers. Kezia, I suppose you didn't see some papers on a table in our room. Mother asked the question that, Kezia, maybe I suppose that you have not, or you didn't see the papers, right? It was on the bed table in my bedroom. Oh yes, she said, I tore them up for my surprise. Now she answered like, yes, of course I have seen. Actually, I tore it for my surprise. Oh my God, now Kezia ne kya kar diya? She tore all those important speech paper of her father to fill the cushion. What happened? Let's see. What? Screamed mother. Screamed means loudly. Mother angrily asked the question like, what? Come straight down to the dining room this instant. Instant means at this time, very quickly. So mother told her that please, means she ordered her that quickly come to the dining room fast. And she was dragged down to where father was passing to and fro, hats behind his back. To and fro means when you are in angry mood, you are running here and there. You know, now sometimes some people have this habit that if they are in tension, they're running here and there to keep their hands behind their backs like that. The father was walking over there. Well, he said sharply. He sharply said, well, mother explained. He stopped and stared at the chart. Father stopped to walk in angrily, and he looked constantly at the little girl Kezia. Did you do that? No, she whispered. She was whispered means gungunana. Okay, bachcho, here when you are whispering in the ear to someone in the ear like that, so in a low pitch of low sound, it's called whispering. Okay, so she was whispering like no, when father asked that, did you do that? Did you tore all the pages, all the pages? Then she was giving answer with stammer. Mother, go up to her room and fetch down the damn thing. Damn means useless things. See that the child's put to bed this instant. Mother, now go up to the room to fetch down that damn things, to take that important paper where the Kezia tore and fill in the cushion. So she took it and instantly she kept it on the bed. Caring too much to explain, she lay in the shadow room watching the evening light make a sad little pattern on the floor. Too much explanation she gave to the crying too much to explain means she was very sad, and as her father and mother scolded her too much, so she was crying. And at that time she was alone in the room, and she looked at the shadow, and it's looking like very gloomy. It's looked like sad little pattern. Then father came into the room with a ruler in his hands. Now father came into Kezia's room with a big ruler. I am going to beat you for this, he said. Now father said that I am going to beat you means he said that I will hit you with this ruler. Oh no, she screamed. She loudly said, oh no father, please don't do, hiding under the bedcloth. And she was hiding under the bedcloth as she was very frightened that my father today beat me a lot with the ruler. He pulled them aside. Sit up, he ordered, and hold out your hands. He put that ruler aside and he ordered to the little girl that sit up fast and hold your hands, means hold out your hands, like when we fold out our hands, no? Like that. You must be taught once and for all not to touch what does not belong to you. It means now father strictly warned this little girl that you must know the knowledge regarding the important things, that you should not touch any important things without asking anyone. Without permission, you should not take any things in the home. But it was for your B-day, she replied. But father, it was for your B-day. I was not trying to waste all the things. I was not trying to make you so sad. I did that so because of your birthday. Down came the ruler on her little pink palm. Finally, father hit the ruler on her pink palms, on her pink hand. Pink hand means pink palms, means as she was very little girl, so she was soft and her hand was soft, and that's why. Hours later, when grandmother had wrapped her in a shawl and rocked her in the rocking chair, the child clung to her soft body. Now at night, when the little girl was so frightened, grandmother tried to rocked her in the rocking chair. Rocking chair, if you have seen that, the chair can moving here and there, so that kind of chair were there. So grandmother was trying to wrapped her with the shawl with the warm cloth and tried to sleep her. "What did God make feathers for?" she sobbed. Sobbed means she was crying with such a voice, like when a little boy or girl crying means वो जो sob करते हैं हम बोलते हैं ना जब रोते हैं रुक रुक के like that when you are frightened and you are crying with such a hurt that's called sobbed. She sobbed and she asked the question, "What did God make fathers for? Why God made fathers? I think God should not make father in the world. Father are very bad." So she was asking such a question like to grandmother. "Here's a clean hanky, darling." Grandmother gave a hanky so that that little girl can use that hanky to wipe all the tears. "Blow your nose. Go to sleep, pet. You will forget all about it in the morning." Pet means, here we know the pet means the animal, the friendly animal at home. But here, grandmother used the word pet for the little child. He told her that please take this hanky and blow your nose. As we know, when we cry, our nose filled with the cough, that's why. And she said that go to sleep, in the morning you will forget all the things about today. "I tried to explain to father, but he was too upset to listen tonight." She said, "I tried to talk to father and explain that why I tore all that pages. I didn't want to do that, but because of his birthday, I did that so. But he was very upset today." But the child never forget. Next time she saw him, she quickly put both hands behind her back and a red color flew into her cheeks. But next day morning, she didn't forget all those things what happened yesterday. When she looked at the father, she suddenly took her hands behind the back, and the face became so red as she was very, very frightened from the father. So today for student for today, this much only. So other paragraph or other story, the conclusion and the middle part of the story will explain you in the next video. Till then, students, stay home, stay safe, learn well. Thank you.